हेलो फ्रेंड्स, केजी क्लासेस में आपका स्वागत है। आज हम आपको शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर ऑफ मैथ्यू अर्नोल्ड के बताएंगे। क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट, राइट ए नोट ऑन अर्नोल्ड्स पोजीशन एज ए क्रिटिक। आंसर, अर्नोल्ड वाज नॉट ओनली ए क्रिटिक ऑफ लिटरेचर, ही वाज इक्वली ए क्रिटिक ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म। ही नॉट ओनली लेड डाउन द फंक्शन ऑफ लिटरेचर, ही आल्सो लेड डाउन द फंक्शन ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म। ही Not only criticized art and literature himself, he also taught other how to critique them. For these reasons, in the famous essays on the function of criticism, Arnold clearly defined and laid down the importance and role of critic in respect of society and in respect of art and literature. Arnold told that great literature cannot be created with a great critical effort behind it. Criticism makes an intellectual atmosphere round him in which the creation of great literature becomes possible. So, Jones says, English criticism cannot be said to have begun and ended with Arnold. Before him, there was a splendid quash, and after him, an overwhelming food flood. Scott James compares him with Aristotle himself. Saintsbury went to the extent of saying that Arnold was the greatest critic of Europe in the 19th century. He says, as I look back over European criticism for the years which have passed since his birth, I cannot find one critic born since that time who can be ranked above on even with him in general critical quality and accomplishment. Question second, what is the function of criticism according to Arnold? Answer, Scott James says that the function of Arnold's critic in the broadest sense of the term is to promote that part of culture which depends upon knowledge of letters. Defining literature as a criticism of life, Arnold says that the duty of a critic of literature is to bring it out into the open in the life of society, a disinterested endeavor to learn and propagate the best that is known and thought in the world, and thus to establish a current of fresh and true ideas. That is the primary function of the critic. Arnold describes three broad functions to a critic of literature. First, the critic's duty is to learn and understand things as they really are. His second task is the task of a missionary to make the best ideas prevail. Thirdly, his function is to prepare an atmosphere favorable for the creative genius of the future. Promoting a current of ideas in the highest degree, animating and nursing to the creative power. Question third, how does Arnold discuss disinterestedness? Answer, Arnold says that the critic cannot discharge his duty towards literature and towards society until he cultivates the rare virtue of disinterestedness. Explaining this point, Arnold writes in the essay on the function of criticism that a critic should keep himself aloof from the practical view of things, resolutely following the law of its own nature, which is to be a free play of the mind on all subjects which it touches. He must steadily refuse to lend himself to any of those ulterior political practical considerations about ideas which plenty of people will be sure to attach to them. The business of a critic is simply to know the best that is known and thought in the world, and in its turn, by making this know, to create a current of true and fresh ideas. The critic's business is to do this with flexible honesty and with due ability, and to leave alone all question of practical consequence and applications. A healthy criticism is not the handmaid of any particular school or group or party. इट इज एब्सोल्यूटली एंड इंटायरली इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ देम. द प्रैक्टिकल मैन सीज एज ऑब्जेक्ट एज हेल्पिंग एंड हिंडरिंग हिज प्लान्स. द क्रिटिक मस्ट ट्राई टू व्यू इट डिटैचडली टू सी इट एज इन इट सेल्फ इट रियली इज. क्वेश्चन फोर्थ, व्हाट इज अर्नोल्ड कंसेप्शन ऑफ लिटरेचर. आंसर, इन द एसे ऑफ ऑन हीन अर्नोल्ड डिफाइंस लिटरेचर एज ए क्रिटिसिज्म ऑफ लाइफ. पोइट्री एज द बेस्ट ऑर्गन ऑफ लिटरेचर इज द ब्रीथ एंड फाइनर स्प्रेड ऑफ आल नॉलेज. द इम्प्रेसेंड एक्सप्रेशन विच इज इन द कंटिन्यूएंस ऑफ आल साइंस. द फंक्शन ऑफ पोइट्री इज टू इंटरप्रीट लाइफ फॉर अस, टू कंसोल अस एंड टू सस्टेन अस. अर्नोल्ड डिस्क्राइब्स वेरी हाइट्स डेस्टिनीज टू पोइट्री. ही सेज विदाउट पोइट्री अवर साइंस विल अपियर इनकम्प्लीट एंड मोस्ट ऑफ व्हाट नाउ पासिस विद अस फॉर रिलीजियस एंड फिलोसफी विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाई पोइट्री. He believes that science, religions, Christianity itself may fail, but poetry will last. In poetry, mankind will find, as time goes on and as other helps fail, it consolation and stay. If will be describe these high destinies for poetry, and if we expect poetry to be capable of fulfilling these high destinies, we must set our standard of poetry very high. It is in this sense that Arnold described high seriousness as the basic attribute of great poetry must be moral. The term moral must be interpreted in its largest sense. Whatever bears upon the question how to live comes under it. Question 5th, write a note on Arnold's insistence on excellent action. Answer, Saintsbury says that Arnold's insistence on the character of the subject was his critical being's very end and aim. Arnold wants to say that the modernness or antiquity of an action has nothing to do with its fitness for poetical representation. The date of action signifies nothing. What matters is that it must be grand. He says all depends upon the subject. Choose a fitting action. Penetrate yourself with the feeling of the situation. This done, everything else will follow. He further says that those actions are the most excellent action which most powerfully appeal to the great primary human affection. So those elementary feeling which subsist permanently in the race and which are independent of time. Arnold believes that a great poem cannot be written on a small subject. Those who seek to write great poetry an inferior subject are doomed to failure. He says it is a pity that power should be wasted and that the poet should be compelled to impart interest and force to his subject instead of receiving them from it and them by doubling his impressiveness. Question 6. Discuss the grand style as presented by Arnold. Answer, Arnold believes that grand style is indispensable for great poetry. He says that grand style arises in poetry when a novel nature poetically gifted treats with simplicity or with severity a serious subject. Saintsbury says that Arnold makes it almost his battle charge. Presented Homer, Dante and Milton as the greatest master of it. He attributed simplicity to Homer and severity to Milton. Arnold believed that of all English poets up to his time, Milton alone had his hold on it. Even Shakespeare did not always write in the grand style. The grand style is in fact a fresh formulation of the classical restraint फिटनेस प्रोपोर्शन एंड फॉर्म अगेंस्ट द रोमांटिक बॉग्यूनेस द रोमांटिक फैंटेसी द ग्रैंड स्टाइल इज ए पोएटिक कंप्रोमाइज बिटवीन द एक्सीलेंस ऑफ मैटर एंड एक्सीलेंस ऑफ मैनर आर्नोल्ड बिलीव्स दैट दीज टू एक्सीलेंस आर इंटरडिपेंडेंट ऑन ईच अदर क्वेश्चन 7 डिस्कस आर्नोल्ड टच स्टोन मेथड आंसर आर्नोल्ड इंट्रोड्यूसेस ए वेरी नोबल एंड प्रैक्टिकल डिवाइस टू डिटेक्ट द ऑर्डर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस इन ए गिवन पोएम ही कॉल्स इट टच स्टोन मेथड ही राइट्स इन द स्टडी ऑफ पोएट्री क्रिटिक्स गिव्स देमसेल्व ग्रेट लेबर टू ड्रॉ आउट वाट इन द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कंस्टिट्यूट्स द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए हाई क्वालिटी ऑफ पोएट्री इट इज ए मच बेटर सिंपली टू हैव रिकोर्स टू कंक्रीट एग्जाम्पल टू टेक स्पेसमेंस ऑफ पोएट्री ऑफ द हाई द वेरी हाइएस्ट क्वालिटी एंड टू से द करेक्टर्स ऑफ ए हाई क्वालिटी ऑफ पोएट्री आर वाट इज एक्सप्रेस्ड देयर दे आर फार बेटर रिकोगनाइज बाई बींग फेल्ट इन द वर्स ऑफ द मास्टर देन बाई बींग परसुएड इन द प्रोज ऑफ द क्रिटिक एक्सप्लेनिंग हिज मेथड ही सेज इंडीड देयर कैन बी नो मोर यूजफुल हेल्प फॉर डिस्कवरिंग वाट पोएट्री बिलोंग्स टू द क्लास ऑफ द truly excellent and can therefore do us most good than to have always in one's mind lines and expression of the great master and to apply them as a touchstone to the other poetry. Arnold believes that it is an infallible touchstone for detecting the presence or absence of high quality and also the degree of this quality in all other poetry which we may place beside them. Thanks, best of luck.